We want to solve the trig equation on the interval from 0 to 2 pi. Since both these terms contain a factor of sine theta, we'll set the equation equal to 0 and then solve by factoring. So the first step is to add 8 sine theta to both sides of the equation. So we'll have 10 sine theta cosine theta plus 8 sine theta equals 0. Now the greatest common factor between these two terms would be 2 sine theta. So we'll factor out 2 sine theta. This will leave us with 5 cosine theta plus 4. And this product is equal to 0 when 2 sine theta equals 0, or when 5 cosine theta plus 4 equals 0. Well, dividing both sides by 2, we would just have sine theta equals 0. Over here, we would subtract 4 and divide by 5, so we have cosine theta equals negative 4/5. Well, we should recognize that we can find a sine function value of 0 on the unit circle, so let's first find the solutions to this equation. Since on the unit circle, y is equal to sine theta, we're looking for a y-coordinate of 0 on the interval from 0 to 2 pi, including 0, but not 2 pi. Notice how we have a y-coordinate here at 0 degrees or 0 radians, as well as here at 180 degrees or pi radians. So these are the two solutions that we can obtain from this first factor. Now looking at the second equation, cosine theta equals negative 4/5, we're not going to find this cosine function value on the unit circle or from reference triangles. So we'll have to use the calculator to help us solve this equation. But we should recognize that since cosine theta equals x divided by r, and this cosine function value is negative, then the x coordinate must be negative, and therefore the solutions to this equation must be in quadrant 2 or quadrant 3. But before we go to the calculator, if cosine theta equals negative 4/5, then theta is going to be equal to inverse cosine of negative 4/5. This is what we'll type into the calculator to find one of our solutions. We do want to confirm that we are in radian mode first. Press the mode key. We are in radian mode. So we'll go back to the home screen. We're going to press second cosine negative 4/5. This angle is greater than pi over 2 radians, and therefore this is in the second quadrant. We'll go ahead and say this is approximately 2.498 radians. So we'll go ahead and sketch this angle in the second quadrant. So let's go ahead and write this down. We have theta is approximately 2.498. But because the cosine function value is also negative in the third quadrant, But because the cosine function value is also negative in the third quadrant, we do have to find another solution. To do this, we'll have to find the reference angle for this angle here, and then sketch the same reference angle in the third quadrant to find the solution in this quadrant. So to find this reference angle, we'll take pi radians and then subtract 2.498 radians. Again, pi radians would be half a rotation counterclockwise, and then we'll subtract out this angle here, leaving us with this reference angle. So the reference angle is approximately 0.644 radians. So now we'll sketch the same reference angle in the third quadrant to find our other solution. So our second solution would be this angle here, which would be pi radians plus the reference angle of 0.644. So our solution in the third quadrant is approximately 3.786 radians. So the given trig equation has four solutions. So our trig equation has four solutions on the given interval. Again, this interval is closed on 0, meaning it includes 0, and it's open on 2 pi, meaning it does not include 2 pi. So we have a total of four solutions. Two solutions here in exact form, and two solutions here rounded to three decimal places. I hope you found this explanation helpful.